What's going on? What the deal is, people? So let's buzz the head open some more. And we're going to talk about the God of the Bird, the Jubilee, the Phoenix, tied his hand with these wings, the Baphomet, the Owl, planes, all of that stuff. Because this represents freedom. And you know that the Bible, the scriptures even discuss this stuff. So this is a continuation. I discussed with y'all with the magnets, leprechaun, etc., etc. You know, and basically right here, this is based on black magic, you know, witchcraft and stuff, transforming your soul into a bird, you know, raven. And because this is one of the birds that's used, like the crows, the molech, which is the owl, bats, because there's good animals with birds and there's bad birds. Just like there's good people, there's bad people. There's good angels, and then there's fallen, petrified demons, such as you. You know, the spies and stuff like that listening. Whoa, Wicca. And I discussed this long ago. I look at your loser owl staring back at you. The molech, you know, based on evilness, Prince of Darkness. That's what the owl represents. Now, what do you see ironically on this picture that you always see? Since I'm discussing bird, what do you see? On this loser, that's right, you see dark wings. Because once the angel is fallen, they become dark in heart, body, soul, and most cases. Now we know God don't do everything the same. Just like they switch stuff up, but there's your loser star. I know this is not how a star really looks, but the best way, this is the best thing humans could come up with to describe the star. I'm gonna connect this stuff for y'all.
Claire!
What the hell?
What's wrong with their eyes?
Another good topic. Fallen angels, like I just showed you, they become dark and heart. You have the spiritual realm, the welfare. And oh, another thing, I'm gonna go back to this loser real quick. When I talk about the five-star beast, I'm talking about the element. I know most people, they think I'm talking about the Baphomet because of this and all of that stuff. Element have many different powers. It's not one body. You know? The Rabusul, it's the ghost, ghouls, and demon, are fallen angels that are transformed into vampire spirits. They mainly appear in human form with demonic features and angelic wings. On this earth, they lurk in the shadows. And I discussed with y'all the shadow god in the ending days, which is another situation. You had a dragon in Revelations. What this Jubilee Phoenix situation, the Jubilee controls the fire. Far as manipulating it, different directions, amplifying it, or witchcraft, demonic situations. The fire bird, you know, during the plague days, doctors wore these bird-like masks to, you know, avoid becoming sick. They would fill the beaks with spices and rose petals. And this was back in the days. Notice that now, at football games, basketball games, these mascots look like birds. You know, birds represent, it's seen every day. I love birds, the good ones. And I'm gonna tie this in with music. The brilliantly colored phoenix was said to possess eternal life. Legend has it that each time the bird died.
I want to help you.
Help me. What's wrong with me?
Absolutely nothing. Eric, stop! No, Charles, not this time. You've always held her back. For your own good, Gene.
Stay out of my head.
I'm going in.
The professor said he'd handle this.
Look at me, Gene. I can help you. No. Look at me.
Get out of my head.
Perhaps you should listen to her, Charles.
You must trust me. You're a danger to everyone and yourself. But I can help you. I think you are to give her the cure. Look what happened to Scott. You killed the man you loved because you couldn't control your power.
No, stop me!
It would rise again from its own ashes. The phoenix had the most beautiful song of any animal on earth and could fly farther and faster than any bird. We're gonna leave that up for grabs, because I'm gonna discuss that another time. We're gonna talk about the anatomy real quick on and, you know, the wings of an angel, because they do exist. Most people have them locked up. Some people seen them up close. Different colors, black, blue, green, white. You know, you get what I'm trying to say. Deltoids and triceps. This allows independent movement from the primary deltoids and torus through stretching. And it will cause the wings to lock and straighten in a downward position to compensate for balance. So even with the movement, the movements of these wings was unique. It's how we came up with planes, which is, you know, the physical realm. This is the spiritual realm. Most people is fighting it every day, meaning trying to go against God every day and trying to do evilness. Here's an airplane wing, and here's a bird wing, which gave people the ideas. This is the spiritual realm. This is the realm that we can see, you know. When it comes to this fight, yeah, birds, you see, and y'all already know this part. Like I told you, I believe this movie Cinderella, something like that. But you see the raven once again on his witch throne, whatever that is. Yeah, it's even in cartoons for individuals who didn't know. It's another cartoon with Mighty Ducks, something like that. They go to raven again. You see all black for darkness. All they do is do evilness of their master, well, whoever they serve. You gotta understand, folks, it's different. There's many different types of of gods out here. Then you have atheist people. And he said to them, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. The only way to fall from heaven is through the power of God. You know, he was tired of their foolishness. Does even God get tired? On the money, the bird is everywhere. Got your 13 arrows, your 13 bulls, or vice versa, the stars. Depending on how people use it, you have it.
1. Phoenix. Jean has probably died more times than any other character in the Marvel Universe, and each time she comes back stronger than before, much like a phoenix rising from the ashes. Her telepathy and telekinesis enable her to control and hypnotize others, fly, create force fields, project concussive blasts, manipulate matter at the subatomic level, and open wormholes that let her travel through the universe faster than light. Her power is so great that she strikes fear into the hearts of other Omega mutants like Magneto, and has tried to be controlled on numerous occasions by powerful entities like the Hellfire Club.
On the United States flag, the eagle, once again, you have an Elmo with Big Bird. There's a lot of people are Big Birds, big losers. You know what I'm trying to say. The bird, let's discuss this bird. Like I say, you folks didn't think I was gonna forget, did you? The God Bird. There you go again. Is everyone? It's on every cop, you know, and it's on every quarter. Know what I'm saying? Our soul has escaped as a bird out of the snare. Of the fouling snare is broken, and we've escaped. Something close to that, but that's in Psalms 124. And God describes situations. You see how he even used situations. Our soul has escaped as a bird out of the snare. Because once you, those wings represent freedom. See, notice I didn't even get to that part. And I said that in the beginning, you know, you get it. There you go again. Based on Revelations, which will be in the ending days. This whole shadow God situation. The Revelations, dragons. And you had a manipulating psychic fire tormenting. You know, this is just basically... it's an enhancer. You know? What this is, Twitter. There go the bird again. I didn't even know I had this picture. But what this is, the dove. Yeah, I believe this is the dove. Those wings represent freedom. And there you go again. The phoenix. Most people represent this spirit. People sacrifice animals all day, and they worship animals just like, if you could worship a calf in the days of Moses, then why not worship a phoenix? Why not worship a Baphomet? Why not worship some stuff you can't see, or a mere man, woman, or even a child? Nowadays, some people were even worshiping disabled people, people in comas, or even dead. When the dead can't hear you, they're gone. You know. Let's break down this bird. And like I say, to scare off evil spirits, music. Depending on how you use anything. And being that this is the world of Lucifer and Satan, they control the music. Because the music is meant to help the people. And since Satan was a head authority of music in heaven, which created the phoenix, Because remember, they had wings in heaven. And like I discussed with you in the beginning, you've seen that the phoenix, all birds make music. All birds make music with their mouths. That's what they're doing. When you hear them out there, they're singing. That's why you have a chapter in the Bible called Psalms, songs, and so forth and so forth. You know, you got hidden symbols, hidden things. Even in Egypt, they go to Eagle again. If I'm wrong about this information, how did I line it up like this? And why is it everywhere? Just answer those two questions. Because I'm only using 2% of my real power. I've discussed this. This information, this is just the tip of the iceberg. You losers are done for. Y'all are lazy. Don't want to put in the real works. Or don't follow your real...
All of these nasty pathogens have surfaced in humans in just the last 50 years, and they are all carried by bats. Which, to be clear, really isn't bats' fault. The recent rise in outbreaks is likely due to humans and our animals creeping ever farther into bats' territory, especially in the tropics. In Malaysia, for example, the spread of commercial pig farms into bat-inhabited forests led to the first human outbreak, via pigs, of Nipah. And in Australia, human Hendra cases are cropping up as destruction of native forests forces fruit bats to feed in suburban gardens. But still, bats do appear to carry more human-killing diseases than pretty much any other animal.
Messiah, you want to sit and argue with me, say, oh man, but his name not Jesus. And then we have to go through the name bickering. And then the skin color bickering. Or whatever. You know, I argue about the truth. You just look stupider and stupider. Like this loser right here. Let's zoom in. Look at him. You have an eagle bird. But look how people use and flip information. Now you have it on a dollar. They tell you money's the root of all evil. They try to leave you poor, broke. You have to go through all of this madness just to get a little peace, a little bit of peace in this life. You understand? Oh, let's bust this back. Four, down, up, you know? Yeah. Eagle represent peace, like I was just telling you. You understand? The God of birds. Are you understanding? You catching on now, folks? You didn't think I was gonna forget about the bird. I'm not forgetting ants, cause not even they gonna make it in the end. The red ants, you know, stuff like that. Most folks played around. Play with my life. I'd rather play with yours. Here we go. I just wanted to share this information and bust down this bird god. More to come in the near future. Retirement coming soon. You know, I hope I got as much as I can out. And understanding this phoenix, the jubilee. You know, the jubilee, yeah, that's a strong meaning. You gotta understand this spirit bird that represents psychic powers, mind control, etc., etc. That's why I'm lining all of this stuff up. So I hope you enjoyed this topic. My name is Joshua. Thank you for listening.